Hello students, today I am to discuss about the fungi Basidiomycota. It is your paper 2016 unit number 5. So firstly, what is Basidiomycota? Basidiomycota are some fungi, no? These are some general characteristics of Basidiomycota. You write in your copy. And I am going to tell about other characteristics of Basidiomycota. And these characters also you write in your copy. So some characters, somatic body is made up of mycelium of well-developed freely branched. Somatic body is made up of mycelium of well-developed freely branched. Number two, hyphae become interwoven, forming rhizomorph, sclerosia and sporophore. There are three types of mycelia found in Basidiomycota. That is primary mycelium, and secondary mycelium, and number three, that is tertiary mycelium. Okay, then the basidiocarp is complex and multicellular. Clamp connection is a common feature. These are some general features of Basidiomycota, and these are also some characters that basidia are born on fruiting bodies. There basidia are some born sexual spores. The spores are known as basidiospores. Basidia are born on fruiting bodies. They are called basidiocarps, which are large and conspicuous in all but the yeast, rust and smut. Yeast, rust and smut, you have to remember it. So firstly, you know syllabus, that is the first genus is Puccinia. So what is Puccinia? It is also a fungi, and the Puccinia is a causal organism of the disease black stem rust on wheat. Wheat, you all of you know what is wheat. So Puccinia causes the disease black stem rust on wheat. And these are the some scientific classification of Puccinia: kingdom fungi, division Basidiomycetes, class Puccinomycetes, order Puccinales, family Puccinaceae, and genus Puccinia. You have to write till the genus, okay? Then, these are the systematic position of Puccinia. That is kingdom fungi, division Amastigomycetes, subdivision Basidiomycota, class Basidiomycetes, order Euryadinales, family Puccinaceae, and genus Puccinia. Okay, and before writing the genus, you have to write the taxonomic position. It is mandatory. Okay, then there are five life cycle of Puccinia. Five life cycle. Okay, you have to study all these five life cycle in Puccinia. Number one, that is Euryadinal stage. What is that? Is Euryadinal stage. Number two, that is Telial stage. Number three, basidial stage. Number four, pycnial stage. And number five, acial stage. These are all these are five stages of life cycle in Puccinia. Okay. Then firstly, what is Euryadinal stage? In Euryadinal stage, we always found the euryadospore. You have to remember it. In Euryadinal stage, we always found the euryadospore. Okay. So, in this first phase, in late spring, vertically elongated reddish bound sori appear on the leaves and stem of wheat plant. Huh? Reddish brown spot are in the leaves of wheat. Hmm? So, what is Euryadinal stage? The euryadospores are one called two nucleus of some white of what a globus, slightly thick white spores. Okay, these spores form on the stalk. The spores exert pressure on the euryadinal epidermis, causing breakdown of the host epidermis to form euryadinia, and this stage is known as the euryadinal stage. So this is about the euryadinal stage. You write this. Then number two, telial stage. What is telial stage? I'm writing about the telial stage here. You copy this. What is telial stage? The middle of the summer season. The stelial stages are found the middle of the summer season. Okay. The mycelium originating from germination of euryadospore begin to form black pustules or soli, telutosoli. They are called telutosoli. The black pustules are called telutosoli. So, these the telluriosauria alloys form in telial cell. So, this is known as telial cells. So, why it is called telial cells? Because telluria spores are found here. Number three is basidial stage. So, what is basidial stage? In this stage, telluriospore sends an outgrowth, promycelium. That's telluriospore. It is an outgrowth known as promycelium. Under favorable conditions of temperature and moisture, each telluriospore germinate. So, the telluriospore are germinate into new plant in favorable condition. Okay? They are favorable condition, the temperature, moisture, fooding condition, etc. Then it germinate into new plant. The field diploid nucleus moves towards the promycelium, undergoes meiotic division. You have to remember it is undergo meiotic division because it is reproduction, followed by the formation of a transverse septa, separating the nuclei from one another and thus from four nuclear cells, which are known as basidium are found. So, in basidial stage, we found basidium. So, it is called basidial stage. And the telluriospore germinate in the favorable condition. You may remember it, huh? You have to remember it. Okay? Then, number four is pycnidial stage. So, what is pycnidial stage? Pycnidial stage. Pycnidial stage, suppose in barberry plant, basidiospore germinate by putting forth germ tube and they directly infect the epidermis. Okay, they directly infect the epidermis in pycnidial stage. In stage, the mycelium produced by germination of basidiospores is monokaryotic. Sometimes it is only monokaryotic. You have to remember this is the major point that it is monokaryotic. It forms the small notch just below the upper epidermis. Then these are transformed into flux-shaped cavities called spermatia. What is a flux-shaped cavity? It is not known as spermatia. And you have to remember it. What is spermatia? The monokaryotic mycelium accumulate beneath the epidermis of in barberry plant. In barberry plant, the monokaryotic mycelium found in the beneath the epidermis, a lower side of the epidermis. Some sterile hyphae are also found, which are called paraphysis. So, sometimes you may ask some question, what is paraphysis? So, what is paraphysis? Then you have to write some sterile hyphae. Paraphysis are some sterile hyphae which are found in the sterile hyphae which are found in vaccinia. So, they are called paraphysis. This is the fourth stage, and number five stage is the ACL stage. It is known as the ACL stage. So, what is ACL stage in barberry plant? It is an example. In barberry plant, the receptive hyphae, the nucleus of the spermatium divides several times, and the daughter nuclei migrate into other nuclei. As the spores are mature, the wall of the peridium ruptures and cup-shaped structure known as ascidium. Okay, and this is known as ascidium. And so, this is called ascidial stage because ascidium are found here. It is known as ascidial stage. Here, the dikaryotic mycelium again bear uridospores in uridosauri. Okay, uridospores in uridosauri, and thus life cycle of Vaccinia graministitic is completed. Here I have not mentioned the species, I have only mentioned the genus. Okay, so the Vaccinia, there are several genus. No? So you have to write, if you have to ask to write the species, then you write Vaccinia graministitic. And the Vaccinia graministitic is completed if life cycle in how many stages? It is 5 stages. Is completed in its life cycle. So diagram, it is a diagram of these are the pycnospores. These are the pycnospore you see here. And this is the pycnospore. These are structure of pycnospore. And this ACA in barberries plant. This is the example of barberries. And these are the ascospore. And these are round in structure. These are Euridinia, then telia. Telia are some black spot-like structure in the wheat stem. And it is found in summer condition. The telluriospore are found The teletospore are found in summer condition. Then the teletospore converted into three chamber. This is winter and this is spring. In winter and spring season, their structures are different. You see here, here are two chamber. This is two chamber and here basidiospores are observed from this and it is into a new plants, growing to a new plants. And this is the asexual life cycle in summer position, asexual. This is the uridinospore. So it is the life cycle of Praxinia graminis. Okay. So it is a thorough study of Praxinia. If you have any queries, then contact me. Okay. Thank you.